Genesis chapter 8, verse 20 and verse 21. And Noah built an altar unto the Lord, and took of every clean beast and of every clean fowl, and offered burnt offerings on the altar. And did not smell a sweet savour, and did not say in his heart, I will not again curse the ground anymore for man's sake. Of course, you know Noah was the person God used to save a remnant when he destroyed the whole world. And after the flood, the first thing Noah did when he came out of the ark was to build an altar unto God. And two things happen immediately, he built an altar. The Bible says that God was pleased with the altar. The sacrifice of the altar was pleasing to God. And God revoked the curse on the earth. And God made a covenant that he will no more destroy the earth. Now, several lessons we can learn from these two verses. The number one thing is that, you see, the first thing Noah did when he came out of the ark was to build an altar, which means anywhere you go, any new place you go, the first thing you should do is to build an altar for God. Now, an altar is a place of fellowship, a place of fellowship with God. An altar is a place of divine encounter with God. An altar is the place you talk to God, you cry to God, you worship God. An altar is a place, once you build an altar is a place that you recognize that there's a creator and you want to worship your creator. You can make anywhere your altar. The church is an altar, but an altar doesn't need to be as big as a church. Now, anytime I travel and I stay in an hotel, the first thing I do as I enter my hotel room is to build an altar for God inside that room. Because I recognize that I've left my permanent address where I have a place of fellowship. But inside that room, the first thing I do any time I enter an hotel room, as I'm dropping my bag, I build an altar. And what do? I dedicate the room unto God. I flush out every evil spirits from the room. I don't know the person that has used the room before for what purpose. I flush out every evil contamination in the room and I invite the presence of God. I invite the presence of the Holy Spirit into that room. All that is all I you need to do to build an altar. I will enter the room and I said, Spirit of God, come and reside with me in this room. So anywhere you go, the first thing you should do is to build an altar, because you need God, you need the Holy Spirit in every situation. Any new place you go, build an altar to God. We are just a symbolic way of saying, God, come and help me, come and defend me. Another thing we need to know is that as Noah built an altar, God himself recognized the altar. God can smell, and God knows nice smell. He knows the sweet smell. When you do a sacrifice on that altar, you can't build an altar without a sacrifice. You make a sacrifice on that altar. It can be a financial sacrifice. You sow a seed to a ministry. That is a sacrifice. And a quality seed. And God said, the Bible said, God smells a sweet savour. And when God smells, When your altar attracts the smell of God, what do you expect? You expect blessings. You expect open doors. You expect testimonies. So the Spirit of God is teaching us today to build an altar. And don't forget that the greatest altar is your body. Your body, soul, and spirit. That is the greatest altar. So the Spirit of God is living inside you. So be careful what you do with your body. Especially in these days when you people tattoo their body in the name of fashion. Be careful. You are not the owner of your body. Your body is the greatest altar. Be careful what you wear. Be careful the earring Now to use, be careful the necklace you put on. Be careful your ear do. All these multicolors here all over the place. Your body is the greatest altar. Be careful the kind of conversation that comes out of your mouth. Be careful what you watch. Be careful what you say. Don't say, it's my life, it's my body, I can do anything with my body. Your body is an altar. And today I pray for you that you shall serve God with your body, and anywhere you go, you shall be an altar of righteousness, you shall be an altar of holiness. Every strange altar in your life, I command to be broken to pieces. Every strange altar that is speaking against your destiny, against your breakthrough, I command it to be smashed into pieces. Every witchcraft altar that is crying against your breakthrough, I command the Spirit of God, the Rock of Ages, to smash them to pieces. I release the fire of God on the altar of your life. Let your altar consume fire. Let your altar receive fire. Let your altar possess fire. It is well with you. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.